Hey guys, today's video is gonna be a sad one. My girlfriend left me. She saw me playing with other girls too much, and I loved her, man. I love everything about her. I love her long blonde hair, her beautiful green dress. Now she's gone forever.
Pengod? I never left.
Baby?
I was just jealous that you clapped up locals without me with Pendulum Magicians.
I love you!
Can we clap up locals together again?
She came back! She came back! Let's go! I love you! I'm never leaving you again! Today's video, I'm taking NTVN to locals! I love you! Let's go! Wait, what's that? And your mom! I love your mom too! What? Servant's mom has got it going on! You waited so long! Celine, can't you see? I'm the Pengod for you!
I don't want to be rude, but you could be the worst singer in New York.
I'm ready. Today, I'm gonna take my beautiful babies, my Celine, which you can find now on truthgaming.com for $20 off for Black Friday. My servant, hell, even Daddy himself, Daddy and Damien, which you can also find on truthgaming.com for $20 off on Black Friday, / Monday, / Tuesday, / till whenever I feel like it. And we are going to locals, but we're not just going to locals, we're winning locals. Let's go. But I ain't going to no normal locals. I'm going to go invade. I'm not going to go to Game Nation today. I'm going to go invade Team Samurai X1 Dollies. And I'm going to make sure to defeat Team Samurai X1 with our best deck. Let's go. Outside Dollies right now. Let's go. Round one is about to start. Pendulum attack, baby! Let's go! Pendulum's best deck, what can I say?
He's seeing things now.
You're gonna be doing a full deck profile of the updated version of the Pendulum Magician.
Local power! Invisible, baby, because this is Zephyroth. He's not so invisible. I'm Dr. Effect. Oh, it's back, baby. And Damien, Zephyroth Magician, DPE, Scythe. We threw them all together, bro. Let's go. This deck is so broken. This is my new Pendulum deck that I haven't shown anyone yet. I'm saving this for the YCS, and it is so damn broken. I'm facing Live Twin here. I told you, bro, me and Servant, we're back. We threw in some Zephra. We threw in some Magician. Let's go. Easy game one over there. This deck is just so broken. This deck, and look at Mommy Celine just waiting there for you guys to purchase on tripgaming.com. Wow. Today, I get a good feeling about today's tourney, boys. I get a good feeling about today's tourney. Our deck is just unstoppable. Look at how many broken cards. Like, oh my god. Our deck, just look. He makes us go first in game two because obviously he sided every single card in existence against us. The big one issue with this deck is that it does lose to Droll. So he does hit us with the Droll there, and it is not very good against Droll. I'm not going to lie there. He hits us with it evenly, makes it even worse, but at least our DPE is live. Our goal here is to let our DPE stop him from doing an insane board. He goes engage here. He's going to negate, but I'm going to pop so he can come back. He's going to put up his typical board. I have to make sure DPE gets off the field in case he has trouble sending to send. So our DPE in the standby phase will come back now, and you're going to witness the power. And drop phase, actually. Drop phase, Dasher, special Mighty Master. So now you see, just like that, Mighty Master gets a negate. And they're just so crazy what the DPE engine does. Like, not only does it give you the DPE effect that comes back every turn, not only does it give you a draw two, but now it gives us a free special with Mighty Master. This is so broken. It's unreal. Like, it's actually insane how good this deck is. Now there's just nothing he can do to stop us. Chain block everything, pop. There's nothing, like, nothing he can do. Imperm, he's not allowed to play Nibiru in his deck, so we just negate that. Like, there's just nothing he can do at this point. Our deck is just broken, and match one goes to Pengod.
Was my pen deck just too good?
Yeah, the pen deck.
Let's go. Sam's next.
Yo, Sam.
Yo.
Did you win yet?
I'm not
clap up Sam, bro. He better win.
Guys, what I can take away from that round one? Very simple. DPE, best card in Yu-Gi-Oh! Destroyer, Pendulum Enforcer. Best card in Yu-Gi-Oh! I don't care. In every one of your Pendulum decks, you gotta play this card, right? I don't care if it's $100, get a job. You need this card. This card absolutely insane.
Yeah, just keep on going. Yeah.
Yo,
what'd you say?
That win was for you, Sam, bro. How'd you lose, man? Sam, you have to win. You have to face the finals.
Very best deck.
Because I'm combo deck. Because I go first. My hand was Lost World Baby, Nibiru, Dark Ruler.
Oh my god.
And I'm like,
you went second, you won.
I just passed, bro.
Bro, just go second, so moving forward. My man's just ashed to slumber. Let's go.
Isn't that three?
Yeah.
What a loser. Holy. I never see anybody worse than Charlie, guys. Anybody named Charlie? I'm sorry. You're just bad.
Charlie, bro, you gonna take that?
Honestly, bro, honestly.
Round two starting now. Let's go. We're facing off the biggest, freest deck of the planet, Sword Soul. So this is gonna be very easy. We gotta buy. Super excited for match number two over here. We are 1-0. We're facing off against Virtual World. I thought we were facing against Sword Soul, and our deck has an incredible matchup against Sword Soul. But you guys are about to witness some crazy shit going on. Look at this. You guys are going to witness some crazy shenanigans that's about to go down. You guys are about to witness. I've never seen this in my life before. This is not Virtual World, boys. This is actual Virtual World. This is not Virtual World. This is a Virtual World Sword Soul. Holy shit. Because the Virtual Worlds are Worm, there are some ways to play them together. He does Brick over here. We don't have the best hand ourselves, but it's going to be enough. We go Dagda. We want to trigger our Scythe. And we got rid of all the interruptions that we knew that he had. And at this point, we're going to go into a DPE. Our DPE is going to be able to carry us hard. You're about to witness how good DPE is. Like, DPE single-handedly is going to carry us here. If DPE wasn't in, DPE pops the Scythe. Sorry for the glare. DPE is going to pop the Scythe here, pop the cards that he has. He's locked into his extra deck. There's nothing he can do at this point. And simply because of that DPE, we're gonna have such huge advantage. We have the Dasher Special Summon. We have the Celestial Draw 2. It is just unreal what DPE does in this deck, especially in a deck that has such amazing cards. And if you ever want to pop your scales, if let's say Zephyrath clogs it, or if Magician's Clog, you want to trigger Wisdom, whatever it may be, DPE just pops it for you. We're going to draw two, get Servant, and there's nothing you can do at this point. You got Chuche, but we're not going to let that one go because of DPE. We're going to pen something, get follow-up of Joker, normal, effect, plus, resolve Servant. This deck is just so insane. That DPE helps you resolve Servant all you want after turn two, turn three. Servant, access code, game one goes to Pengar. This deck is just so insane. And as you see, yeah, we have to flex different mats each round because we got the best mats in the game. Look at that Mighty Master, bro. That Mighty Master is telling you to resolve your Mighty Master. I am Endymion. That's what I'm telling you to do. Iron Man, as much of a goat Iron Man is, Iron Man got nothing on Endymion, you know? Iron Man, Endymion. Endymion, best deck. Let's go. So, my opponent here, Amar, is going to go for his Virtual World combo. It is super cool that there is synergy with it. The fact that you can use the trap card with any of the Virtual World worms, the fact that you could add any of the worms, it's actually really cool how they work together. So here, he's going to go into Sulkin, set up the Crystal Wing, and then at this point, he's going to summon Mo Yi or Tai Yi. They all look the same. And he's going to put up a big board here. I wonder how his board's going to do. Oh, look at that bicep, bro. Oh, God. I love my bicep. You guys ever just stare at yourself in the mirror after, like, you work out or, like, you brush your teeth and, like, you're just, like, flexing your bicep? Or is that just me? Okay, anyways. Oh, look at those veins come. Oh, fuck yeah. Those veins coming out of my hand. Sorry, guys. I'm going to stop staring at myself. And instead, we're going to focus on this duel. Sets up a massive board. And the board is very cute. Unfortunately, we don't open Sphere Mode. I really wanted a Sphere Mode there, a Dark Ruler, but we did not have access to it. That's all right. We're going to plus as much as we can here. We knew he was going to pop those. We go Servant. He has like 10 negates up here. He pops two. We're still going a bit, but then he uses last negate on Zephyrath, and there's nothing we can do. We almost cleared it all, actually. I think if he had one less negate, we legitimately cleared it all. We set up a DPE through all the interruptions, and DPE would have cleared them all. But now we're going first. We have go pen call here. Playing around Droll because I'm really scared of Droll. That's Magician Souls, which is extremely powerful with Oracle of Zephra. But we already used it, I believe. And then we're going to go get cards up. Prepare, Dagda, Effect.
Then we're going to go into Verte. Sorry for the glare. That was Verte. So he set up a DPE Scythe Baron de Floor. He has Imperm, but we're going to negate the Imperm. And that's the beauty of this deck. It's that we're so protected through all these interruptions. So because he's Scythe locked, there's really nothing he can do at this point. He's just trying to set up. I have Divine Strike too if I really wanted. And he's just trying to set up. And at this point, there's nothing he can do. We just have too many cards. Just going to go for game. And we are now 2-0 Penbest deck. Let's go.
All right, guys, that was intense. We ended up winning, Scythe Lock twice. Penja's best deck, what can I say? So we'll see who we face in the third round, and then we'll see who we face in the fourth. And I think we have... Yo, Stein, is it top cut? Then we'll see who we face in top cut. We got to go through. I told Sam I'm a clap of dollies for him today, so we got to stick with our promise. Let's go. Biggest shout out to Stein! My phone's at 2%. He's going to charge my phone. Let's go. We're going to need it for the finals. Guys, I was charging my phone, so I couldn't record the last match, but it was actually the craziest match in the entire tournament so far. I pengraphed Time Gazer like 17 times in one game. And we were like drawing top deck for top deck to top deck.
Wait, who won
though? I won.
He beat me 2-1. He beat me 2-1. I still won a game though.
It was insane. What do you think of Pendulums, bro? Yo, did you learn about Pendulums a little bit?
Hand best tier 2 deck.
Tier 1 deck? What the heck? Didn't they clap up the birds? Come on. But it was an insane match. I feel sorry you guys missed it. It was actually incredible. All right, guys, last round. We got to win this one to keep up the undefeated record. Let's do this.
Let's go!
Yo, what record are you? X1?
X1, fam. I'm playing Dino today, bro.
Oh, let's go.
Sadly, as I said, my phone died for round number 3. So we're going straight to round 4. And I have 3 Magician Souls in my hand. I'm playing a 60-card deck, bro. And I drew 3 fucking Magician Souls in a 60-card deck. Literally, that alone makes me want to play 2. He ashes the Divine Strike. I'm like, this is so annoying, bro. What I should have done, by the way, had a cooler play. If I specialed Souls first and then normal Souls, I could have gone Dagda, special Zephyr Nui, trigger Dagda, then go into Verte. But this is going to be the battle of the DPEs. Whose DPE is going to be stronger? Let us see. He sets it right away because he wants to get the pop off. So I'm going to go. He uses his first. I use mine next. He pops with the Zephrath there. He has lots of hand traps. He's going to ghost spell my DPE, sadly. I'm going to go Duel Slayer's Pen Call. Literally the best card in my deck, the top deck there. And now, the second I saw that Pen Call, this duel's over. This duel's absolutely over. His sets need to be Solemn Strike or else he's going to get absolutely clapped up. And now at this point, he's going to DPE, but my Iris is protected by Pen Call. This is a beauty of Pendulum. Not many people know what to do at what point. I have Access Code right off the bat because I have to get rid of the strike. And what a Judgment Call, bro. Holy shit. If I did not think he had a strike, what if I just pen summoned and I lost? So Access Code was my bait. Set up a Baron de Floor here with the Zephyr Nui. I just want to pop his set. He has Called By. I'm like, this is fine. Set. We're going to draw 2. And I go Mastery. Search. Draw. Dagda. Set up the Dagda here. I'm going to do a really cool play where Baron de Floor is going to come back in the standby phase to get my own DPE. So Baron de Floor in the standby phase is going to use it to special summon my DPE in the graveyard. Super big brain play. And then I'm going to use that DPE to pop my own Scythe. Massive 10 head play to be able to pop my Scythe. He still has access to Alistair, which is honestly fine. I still have some interruptions, but he's going to use his DPE as well. So I didn't really resolve how my Scythe didn't resolve how I wanted it to. But it's all right. That's okay. So he's going to go Invo. At this point, I recognize I did use this. I did a slight error here. I should have Divine Strike the Alistair. I didn't want him to draw 2. But it's all good. It's all good. So we're not in a good scenario here. My standby now, we're not in a great scenario. I thought maybe I could have played that one a little better. But he had the answer there to the Baron de Floor. So there's nothing we could really do. We go Pen Summon. We activate the effect of the end phase of the Celestial Magician to add. I enter battle for him to waste his Alistair. And I just want to see if he could top deck twice now. And DPE comes back. And I do add the end phase from Celestial. I go Pengraph. Take rid of both because he uses first. And of course, he top decks Invocation. Bro, his top deck game was just insane. And Ogedee is going to be game. So sad, bro. 2 great top decks in a row. Specifically the Invocation, too. That was very unfortunate. Anything else, we would have been good. But we lose game 1 there. We're going to go straight to game 2 now. I need to focus here. I don't want to lose this game. That first match was actually like 35 minutes long. So we don't have much time here for round number 2. So I got to play super fast. And I also need to make sure that that I get a turn to do some damage. So I play as fast as humanly possible. I know that I'm going to be down in life points because I'm going to Verte and Tuning Magician. I think I have 5 minutes left at this point. So I'm going to hope my opponent goes as fast as possible. I set up the Pengraph from popping my own double Iris. And we're going to see what he could do at this point. That's my Scythe set. He goes Dark Hole. I'm like, this is fine. I just need a turn. Pen Call. He actually my Pen Call. My DP comes back. I already declared Pengraph. Gonna pop both. his double invocation. And then at this point, I just need to do some damage. I go Time Star. Time Star get Joker. There's like 2 minutes left at this point. I just attack right away because I don't want to, just in case the time does be called. I normal Joker in main phase 2 now. I want to set up some negates. I go Appaloosa. Set up and for next turn. I have Appaloosa. So he has to do like 6k damage to me. He has like 1 minute left at this point. We realize that he, no way he could do it.
So we end up drawing that game, ending 3-0-1. There'll be enough to top 8, and we're going to go top 8 now. And we're going to take over Dolly's. I already know what it is. Sam, you better have top. Sam, did you win? Did you win?
Yes.
You actually won?
Yeah. Let's go.
Yo, we're going to face each other. Bro, you can't dance, bro.
That's how you dance, bro. You know
that's
how you dance?
No, that's how we dance. So we're about to go next week.
I could call.
We're about to go clubbing after I clap him. All right, guys. These are the packs we get for entry. What's good in these packs? I don't know what is, but we're going to pull something insane. Let's go, guys. We're waiting for top cut now. I hope I face Sam first round so I can get a buy at the top 4. Or some Sword Soul deck, anything like that. Yeah, well, those aren't good. Dawn of Majesty. Yo, what's good in Dawn of Majesty?
Ready Fusion.
Alright, if we pull Ready Fusion, we'll play it in our Pendulum deck for shits and gigs. Despia. That's an ass deck. Oh, let's go Pendulum attack, baby! Let's go! This is the first time we actually pulled a secret in one of these packs after like 100 packs, guys. And of course it's a Pendulum! Let's go!
Is it good, Steven?
No, this card's absolutely ass. Yeah. Never played this card, guys, but it looks super cool. And the fact that our first secret or ultra or ulti since COVID, with the exception of the Kaina, because strikers are useless, is a Pendulum, is absolutely insane. Now it's time to get the Baron de Flor. How insane would it be if this actually was Baron de Flor? Lyrilla's Bird Sanctuary trash. Okay. Burst of Destiny. Yo, DPE comes in this, right?
Yeah, already told DPE.
DPE.
Stratos.
I don't even want a Stratos. I just want DPE. Oh, cool, an Ultra. I'm pretty sure it's worth 1 cent, just like this B Trooper deck. But it's all good, because we pulled the Pendulum Secret. Maybe we'll play it in a deck for fun. But probably not, because it is bad. Anyways, top cut starting now, boys. Let's go. All right, after standings, we are second place. Let's go.
We are facing off against literally the exact same player as we faced in the last round, which is hilarious. But let's go. I want my revenge here because it just ended in a draw in the last one. And I want to make sure that this time I finished victorious. We did open 3 Magician Souls in the first match against this invoked DPE player. But this time around, we are not. We are drawing Servant of Endymion. What did I tell you in the beginning of the video? I told you we were going to clap up. But here we do brick. Wisdomize. After this duel, I recognize Wisdomize is an absolute brick. Look at this, man. This late, we're going to brick with Wisdomize like that. Like, it was very sad for us. But that's fine. Jackal is not gonna be enough either because he's gonna enter battle and things are not looking too hot for us, man. He does start off with Fusion Destiny. The Jackal did stop him there, but I lose game one. I'm like, man, like maybe we gotta cut 60 down to 50 because playing a whole Pen Magician pure engine with the Zephyrs and stuff, the Wisdom Eye will conflict with Endymion. They will conflict with the Zephyrs, and we just break too much there. We also drew the trap, so this is too much. Here we open way better. We have Mastery Duelist Alliance. Pen call, all this. So this is going to be too much. We get set up a Jackal to protect from Nibiru. So we make sure his Nibiru is dead. And I'm going to just calculate here. I want to make sure that we can play through Nibiru Veiler. So we're playing through Nibiru Imperm Veiler, all that stuff. And we're still going to set up our end board. Set up a Scythe here. Go Time Gazer. Get a Verte. So we play through Nibiru Veiler, Imperm Droplets. All this stuff we're playing around. So we're totally good. The Scythe resolves. He's going to Gamma, but we're going to Jackal the Gamma. And there's nothing you can do at this point. He's going to attempt to set up a wall. But there's really nothing he can do. He sets a bunch. He does have a strike, I assume, because I saw strike in the last duel. But I'm going to start popping everything. He strikes the Baron de Flor. I'm like, this is fine. There's still nothing he can do. So we're going to go just pop everything little by little. I'm just going to get my Pen Summon ready and prepared. So at this point, I just Pen Summon. He's like, yeah, it's fine. I calculate. I just do extra damage here. And he's like, yeah, I can't come back from that. So we're going to go on to game number 3 over here. The classic game 3 where you guys are about to witness some of the most high Pendulum gameplay that you guys are ever going to see. The way I actually win this game... Wow. I'm sorry. I just ruined it. But it wasn't really a surprise that I was going to win game 3 or not. But I want you guys to see how I actually come back from this, okay? Absolutely unbelievable comeback. I'm not bad for ruining it, but I don't care. This shouldn't be a surprise anyways. So he goes Alistair. He's playing, so sorry for the glare here. I should have realized the glare. My fault for that. But he goes Kaliga, and he gets rid of the Celestial. So my hand is absolute fucking dog shit, okay? I draw Celestial. I'm forced to allure away my Celestial. So we're both out of DPEs here. So let's see how we could deal with this DPE battle. I Dark Ruler only to add a counter on Abducting. Hits you with Shared Ride. Now, at this point, you guys saw my hand. My hand was absolutely abysmal because of what he had set up. So I go Pen Summon, and I can't add too much because I'm under Shared Ride here. So all I ensure is that I can get enough negates here to stop him on his turn without doing too much. I would love to go into Verte and win the duel here, but I can't. I can't go into Verte. So I set up Dagda, set up Needle Fiber, and at this point, I'm like, man, there's really not much I can do because of what I don't have much against him, and I'm under Shared Ride. So I set one, and I just pass at this. So he goes Normal Summon Alistair. Alistair effect add. Instantly, when he doesn't realize it, I set my Scythe. I TG Wonder Magician, pop my own Scythe, and his Called by the Grave stopped my Divine Strike. And I set up a Brondafleur. So despite having the biggest brick ever, I kept Dagda in post side deck. I kept Scythe post side deck, and it worked out for me. And with my Divine Strike, I negated everything he had. Now, little by little, I want to pop his Interruptions. I go Celine, right off the bat, to summon TG Wonder Magician. He goes to Kokobo. I negate that right away. Access code to pop both of them. And
man, that match was absolutely incredible for those guys. Just saw it. Absolutely insane top eight. We're about to go to top four right now. Sam's playing here, so we're gonna go cheer on Sam. He's facing off against my boy Matthew. So we'll see how they do now in their top gun match. There's only like 3 minutes left. Let's go, boys. Let's go, Sam.
My phone was not charged for game one. I end up winning the dice throw, but I make him go first, and it was a big mistake. He beat me game one. So now we're going straight to game number two over here. This is top four against Sam. So I need to win this one. And I will give you guys a heads up that my phone does end up dying as well in game three. But I'll explain what happened when we get there. Shit, I ruined it again. Clearly, I win game two if there's a game three. But anyways, so here we're going to set everything up. And Dinos, Scythe, it doesn't seem like it. But Scythe does hurt Dinos simply for the fact that with Scythe, they are not allowed to use Evopale because they'll have no non-Dinos unless they draw a Hand Trap. And clearly, he's not playing a Hand Trap version. I help Sam build his deck later. So here you go, double Dark Ruler, but my Scythe resolve. And, you know, double Dark Ruler, Scythe, the only way he wins here is if he gets Conductor to hand. So he's going to do everything he can to try and get Conductor to his hand. So he goes Oviraptor here. He does a very smart play where he goes Oviraptor effect to add. He's going to go Prosperity in a little bit. He has to make sure that he could Conductor Special Summon from hand. That's the only way he could do this. So here next he goes Prosperity, I believe. Yeah, and he's gonna, the only way is if he top decks Abyss, which he does, obviously, because it's Dinos. And he's gonna have to use the Abyss effect for no reason, just to put in the graveyard to special the Conductor. Everything goes by when a Dark Ruler. But that's okay, because we're set up perfectly for a follow-up. I have the most insane top deck sorcerer because Dasher will special the Sork to get Joker. And I just pop that, and I pop the Conductor on standby phase. At this point, there's nothing you can do. We're gonna go straight to game three. Like, there's not, if you don't kill me, there's nothing you can do, because a Pen follow up with DPE is just too broken. That's the beauty of DPE. It gives Pen the most insane follow up ever. Put him under Dweller, and that as game. Now we're gonna go straight to game three over here, and I'm gonna let you guys know right now that game three, my phone does die after he sets up his board, but I'm gonna show you guys the board anyways, and I'm gonna discuss exactly how we deal with this board. So I'm gonna speak a little into the future, but Sam here is going to set up his board, okay? He goes, sets up his entire board, and he, as you guys saw there, he also had a nib, I believe, in his hand, but he sets up an entire board here, and the Dino end board is insane. You know, it sets up, like, Lagia, sets up Omega for Misk follow-up, Conductor, all that jazz. But does anyone know what does a Pendulum side deck look like? Sphere Mode, Lava Golem, Dark Ruler, and you already know what it is. We end up top decking a Sphere Mode, and we just Sphere Mode his board. I do the typical massive board, and I believe I set up Jackal, and there was just nothing you can do at that point. It was GG.
You know, for someone who has an absolutely ginormous brain such as myself, it does tend to be quite tiny sometimes, and I do not recommend going to locals knowing that you're going to vlog the entire locals with like a 40% charge phone. My phone died literally in the top four. So what ended up happening here is I just drew Sphere Mode and I won. It was pretty cheap of a victory. I had Sphere Mode and five broken Pendulum cards. So it wasn't much that Sam could do there. We did end up playing some more because our match was so fast that we ended up just waiting for a while for the finals. So we ended up playing some more, and I told Sam that, you know, I'll tell the world what happened in that one too, and I'm not gonna lie, I got clapped up when we played for fun. But I won the important one, and that's what matters. So we're about to go to finals right now. My phone is plenty charged in the meantime. So we're gonna go to finals. We're actually gonna end up facing Virtual World in the finals. So cheer on your boy. Let's go. Finals now. We are going to face off against my boy Eric. This is Virtual World versus Pendulum. Let's go. We win the dice roll, so that's already GG. Our hand is absolutely bonkers, bro. We're gonna set up everything that we need. This glare is really pissing me off. I'm gonna fix the glare for the next locals that we do at Dolly's. And we just set, look at this, bro. I have Jackal to protect from Nibiru. We got Dagda there to set up our scythe. We got Dweller. We're gonna get Verte. We got Jackal, Dweller, Verte, DPE, Divine Strike, Scythe Lock. This is just absolutely broken. He goes Kowloon. I'm like, that's fine. He's under Scythe in the draw phase. There's just nothing he can do at this point. I have Divine Strike that I'm just saving for anything huge. I Dweller as well, so he can't use anything in the graveyard. And there's just nothing he can do. There's really nothing he can do. He's gonna do his best, but man, like, Scythe Lock against Retro World is just too much, because then you're just up with a bunch of little monsters that do nothing. So there's only hope really to set up Chuche, but I mean, like, I have Divine Strike, I have Pops, there's nothing he can do. So we win game one, then we're gonna go into game two. And game two, Retro World does brick a lot, but when it doesn't brick, it does do a lot of cool things. So we're prepared here, we're gonna set up, when it doesn't brick, it does put up a bunch of monster negates, like four negates. So I assume my Lava Golem, all that Dark Ruler, all that nice stuff to take care of his board. And then all we got to deal with is one Chuche and potential hand trap, so that's nothing for us. He ends up breaking and he sets two, but guess what? He has Imperial Order, and Imperial Order absolutely destroys our hand here because we have all spells. I use Souls here to send one, to draw one. Normal Wisdom, attack at 1500, go Verte, and he's going to hit us with... I knew he had a hand trap, but we're going to try anyways. He had D-Barrier to stop fusion, but we did our best, okay? So we want to put him as low life points as possible, because if he could break long enough until we draw Purple Poison or something like that, we'll be fine. I activate a Zephyrath to try and bluff that I have a Zephyrath. I have Divine Strikes. So I want him to pop my Zephyrath. I keep trying to bait it. At this point, he's at 400 life points, so Order dies. He has Twin Twister. All I need to do is survive. My hand here is like Sphere Mode, Lava Golem, Zephyrath. Like, I have all these sorts of hand. But now that Order is done, I can play a little bit. As long as we don't die, he's at 400 life points. And since he's at 400 life points, I'm trying to bait some of his cards here. Lava Golem, he's at 400 life points! He's at 400 life points! He's at 400 life points! And Lava Golem per game, let's go!
Literally, the most insane card that has never left my side deck for the last 9 years.
So guys, we ended up winning the whole tournament. That was an incredible, incredible tournament. Incredible last round. Guys, we did it for Lava Golem, I love you! I love this card. Literally has never failed me since the beginning of time. Eric, yo, you played great. It's just unfortunate you bricked that last game, the second game. Then we both, like, hey, the Imperial Order came clutch. For once, I actually didn't mind the Imperial Order because I also stopped him from playing.
So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to be doing a full deck profile of the updated version of the Pendulum, Magician, Zephyrath, Endymion, DPE Scythe deck that has won the whole locals with top cut everything. We went undefeated the entire way through. And I'll be doing that in a different video. So make sure to be on the lookout for that so you guys can see it. This deck's absolutely insane. I want to give a massive shout out to everyone at Dolly's. It was an absolute blast to play here. Dolly's was my locals for a long, long, long time. And also want to give a big shout out to Sam. We dueled after for fun. I'm not going to lie. He did whoop my ass. So I have to give it to him for that. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Make sure to check out the next deck profile for this deck. It is absolutely insane. And I'll see you guys at the video.